Excelsior!
Hey guys, I am back. How are you all doing?
Don't worry, I'm fine. Just broke my leg. So, what is going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video, and today we're going to be talking about my experience with witnessing the Endgame. Combination of 11 years, 22 movies, all the way started in 2008 by Iron Man 1 with Robert Downey Jr., Kevin Feige, and the director. Forgot his name. Yeah, the fat guy. John Favreau. John Favreau. He started it all, and the ending of the arc of the first Avengers in 2012, all the Avengers, their arcs, not completely, but this is kind of the endgame for many Avengers. And yeah, before I get into more detail and talk about Endgame, I'm gonna give you a spoiler warning, because if you haven't watched this video, go watch it! Of course, you have to. Like, this is one of the best movies I've ever watched, probably the best one, maybe, I don't know. Go watch it, definitely would recommend it. Don't watch ahead if you haven't watched Endgame. Are you done? Are you gone? Hope so. So, the movie started with Nebula and Stark playing on the table, the finger talkers, whatever it's called. And those moments really were emotional, in my opinion, because it was showing the human part of, she's not really human, but you know, the emotional part of Nebula. She was giving her food to Stark, and it was a depressing moment. All hope was lost, and it was pretty much like, this is the end for the first Iron Man, the first Avenger in a way. But no, Carol Danvers comes to save the day, and everybody finally gets to Earth, and everybody's happy but depressed because 50% of the population is gone after the events of Infinity War, the snap, the decimation event caused by Thanos with all the 6 Infinity Stones. And Tony is disappointed in Cap that they started a civil war instead of making a protective cover all over Earth. And yeah, they fought, and there was no hope really. So all the left Avengers decided to go, and this was ridiculous in my opinion. They just went, and while, you know, Thanos was not even fighting back, he was just speaking out his words. It's revealed that the Infinity Stones are destroyed, which was a pretty big shock. And then, of course, Thor gets in anger and slices his head off, which was ridiculous in my opinion. But yeah, complex emotions, a lot has happened, and Thanos died 5 years later, which was a pretty big shock again. And you know, everything is abandoned, stranded, and There's no hope for anything to come back, but finally Scott Lang comes back from the quantum tunnel. He has spent only 5 to 10 minutes, hours, and years has passed by. He explains how, you know, quantum physics can be used to get the time jump, and the time heist is a pretty weird concept, and it's very, like, to properly understand you have to probably know quantum physics. But yeah, it was interesting. Professor Hulk, we found him because 1.5 years in Gamma Lab, he's finally there, and all the Avengers are ready. Tony wants to do it because he has a daughter now, and he wants to do it because he wants to bring Peter back. So he finally accepts it. They work together, and finally a time machine is made, and they go through it, and amazing moments all the way back to Guardians of the Galaxy 1, Thor 2, and Avengers 1. It was great. They tried to collect all the Infinity Stones from the past to make a gauntlet again and snap everybody back, and they got all the stones, but we know that alternate timelines can be made if any bad things happen with the stones. And if they did, Loki escaped with the Space Stone in New York. The Time Stone was there. Hulk explained that we saw the Ancient One, and how Doctor Strange knew it all along, and he did everything for a reason. And then it continues, and they have messed up. The Space Stone is gone. The moments of Captain America meeting himself and everything, and those references, it was amazing. So now the Space Stone is gone, so they have to go in the past, but they need Pym particles. So they go to a time where Pym particles and the Tesseract can be found in the same area, which is back in the 90s. We saw a cameo from Stan Lee, which was amazing. The guy started it all. Stan Lee, great person, Excelsior. So yeah, we saw that. He met his father, had some talk. Guardians of the Galaxy Nebula connected with the Wi-Fi of the present, the past Nebula, and that screwed everything up. Thanos got the Pym particles, got the got the future Nebula. Now he knows that his head cuts off. He succeeds his plan of getting all the Infinity Stones, and he gets the Pym particles and gives it to Ebony Maw. Yeah, Ebony Maw. He is a very big scientist, so he MacGyvers his way to somehow time traveling his spaceship to the current day of Avengers. He gets his plan. Now their plan is screwed, and of course the reality stone Thor gets. He's fat now. Yes, from all the depression, he's just been dunking beer into his system, and he's just fat. He's filled with carbohydrates, and yeah. So they finally, all the stones are gotten. Tony gets his with his father, has a talk about having a child and everything, which was a beautiful moment. It was necessary. The movie had a lot of moments of just plain talking. I think it was necessary because all the characters are coming to an end, and they needed that. And yeah, it happens. All the Infinity Stones are there now. The Infinity Gauntlet. Who's going to wield it? Hulk does, because the gamma radiation is present in all of these stones, and he is made of gamma radiation. So he puts it on, snaps everybody back, and we know that everybody is back because the Hawkeyes, which is Ronan now, which is most muttering vigilante all the way back in Japan. And yeah, his wife calls, and now we know that everybody's back, which in the starting of the movie, and the movie started that way, yes. Hawkeye's family being dusted off, and then again Captain America has a shield again, and of course Thanos, he gets to the time machine. The past Nebula helps him to get to there. Everybody snap back, and Thanos attacks on the Avengers headquarters, and everything is destroyed. And of course, when everything is lost and everybody knows that this might be the end, the fight with Thanos, which was an amazing fight. It really shows you that Thanos is such a big warrior. He's an intergalactic terrorist. He was being a saint in Infinity War, and without even the stones, he performed in this movie, and he was amazing. His Infinity Sword and the Trinity versus Thanos was amazing. Mjolnir is back. Captain America wields Mjolnir, which was one of the biggest things. Like, wow. He was worthy all along. He just didn't want to crush Thor's ego. And yeah, that happened. And of course, everything it destroyed. Still, Thanos beats everyone. Everyone. He beats everyone. The Trinity, I mean. And there were some cool references there in the fight as well. And then, of course, when everything is lost, Captain America alone stands the whole army, which is filled with Chitauri and the Outriders, Thanos, the Black Order. Everybody is there to fight the Avengers, and there's only Captain America standing. And then, the most amazing moment that I, in my opinion, before I even watched the movie, was in my mind, like the portal opening and all the Avengers. And Captain Black Panther, Falcon, and Falcon comes in. He's like, on your left, which is a great reference. And then all these portals open, and here comes all the Avengers that have been united from all these years. The Soul Stone, yeah. Black Widow was sacrificed, which was a pretty great moment in my opinion. And she sacrificed her all, and yeah. That was something. So her death felt like a little, it wasn't that, you know, it wasn't that big of a rally in a way. But yeah, she sacrificed and we got all the Infinity Stone that way. And then again, and now Thanos is on a new mission. He thinks that humans are just stupid and they cannot live without failure, so they. His new plan is to get the Infinity Gauntlet and snap every single atom in this universe and start a new one. In Hindi, if you have watched it in Hindi, they ruin stuff. They really do. They made him say that he wants to become a god and be prayed from the new world that he's going to make, which was completely ridiculous, and it shows that Thanos is much more of a psychopathic villain, which is he's man on a mission, and in a way I agree with him. Like, he is a villain. He wants to commit mass genocide. Okay, so the video cut out because my battery of my phone was pretty low, so let's continue. And yeah, I kind of agree with Thanos' plan. It was, you know, it has its stakes. I'm not going to get into it in detail-wise because it's a much bigger thing to talk about. But except that all the Avengers come, and of course the Avengers assemble that we have been waiting from the end of Age of Ultron is finally happened. Everybody is there, Ant-Man and the Wasp, everybody, just the Netflix Avengers weren't there. If they were there, it would have been perfect, but I guess we are seeing the movie side. So, everybody, it was an amazing, all the portals, how they fought, and of course Scarlet Witch was amazing. She even broke, we got the A-Force moment, and yeah, that was one of the best moments in entertainment, in the history of entertainment, in my opinion, and I freaking loved it. Avengers assemble. And then again, when Captain Marvel came in, and she tried to get the stones, and Thanos finally gets the gauntlet, but Carol tries to get it off. He tries to headbutt her, but you know, she's powerful. which was a pretty great moment. And then, of course, he took the power stone and just blasted her, which was a pretty good moment. I liked that because it was like he used his intellect to fight her, you know? And it wasn't like Captain Marvel is the best Avenger, she's going to come in and defeat everybody. That didn't happen, which I loved. And of course, then Tony asked Doctor Strange if this is the one time they are going to win. He tells him, I cannot tell you, because if I tell you, it won't happen. And of course, then he shows the one finger. And then, of course, Tony, being the person who learns from his mistakes, how he wasn't able to get off the gauntlet by just forcing it off, he used the nanotech. And of course, the greatest moment in the movie, Tony Stark wearing the gauntlet, all the Infinity Stone, and Thanos does I am inevitable, and of course it doesn't work, and he goes, well, I am Iron Man, which was just amazing. He said, I am Iron Man, not well, but yeah. And then it was a pretty big shot. I thought that Captain America was going to die, but Tony ended up dying. It was a very emotional moment. And then, of course, everybody, we saw Wakanda at night. We saw the kid at the funeral of Iron Man from Iron Man 3. Of course, Morgan, I love you 3000 was a great line, in my opinion, throughout the movie. And then, of course, Captain America goes to put all the stones back, but ends up living his life with Peggy. Now, that happened in an alternate world. Did he create a new timeline? What happened is still to be explained. And then again, of course, Far From Home. I may do a trailer breakdown. Of course, we now know the snap tour of world. A hole in the universe, and now we have access to multiverse, which might be a lie. Mysterio might be lying, but who knows? If he's not lying, this is going to be great. So yeah, that ended, and now we need the new Iron Man, which leads us to Far From Home. So yeah, Avengers Endgame, 11 years of combination. It was a great movie, probably the best movie. Yeah, it is the best movie I have ever watched. I didn't do reviews for Captain Marvel or Ant-Man because Ant-Man and the Wasp, because I didn't feel like anything big was there to talk about. But yeah, both of those movies were pretty great as well. So yeah, that is it for my review for Avengers Endgame. What do you think about the movie? Tell me down in the comments. And what you think that is going to happen in the future of the MCU. We have an Eternals movie, and now the Fox deal is done. So Doctor Doom, Fantastic Four, the Multiverse, maybe the Spider-Verse Into the Spider-Man, and Miles Morales from Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse can also join, maybe. I would love to see Venom as well. And of course, the Fox deal is done, so X-Men and can also come. This is going to be great, but we have to wait a few years, and a lot of planning is to be done. And I cannot wait for the lineup of all the movies that are going to happen in the Summer Comic Con of this year, and that's going to be great. But yeah, one of the best things that has ever happened to my life has been Endgame, and yes, I loved it. Tony's sacrifice was great, the best Avenger, and of course Captain America, Thor gives his royalty to Valkyrie, and all the plot points. It felt like a great end, not like Star Wars The Force Awakens. That was bad. So yeah, that is going to be it for this video, So yeah, that's going to be it for this video. Tell me down in the comments what you think about this video and what you think about the movie. What are your reviews? What are your thoughts about it? If you like the video, then give me a like down below. And subscribe to my channel if you think I'm worthy enough to deserve your subscribe. And thank you guys again so much for watching. Peace, love, and hugs. It's been a pleasure.
writing, I'm pouring my soul into every story I'm writing, producing, I mix it, I master, I'm building my craft and I'm not looking back. I've been going doing things I wanna do when I want to. Everybody wanna get a win, but they not do. Everybody wanna copy you, but they not you. Everybody wanna be cool, but they not new. Whoa, look how I go, don't be a dentist, I still got the flow.